नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि औरा भक्त वृंद जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि औरा भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जय प्रभुपाद जय जय प्रभुपाद जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर सदर्श श्रीमद अभय चरण अरविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राज काचार्य अष्टोत्तर सदर्श श्रीमद भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज प्रभुपाद की जाय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जाय नमाचार्य शिलदास ठाकुर की जाय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद की जाय श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्यामकुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जाय, वृंदावन मथुरा धाम की जाय, मायापुर नवदीप धाम की जाय, गंगा माई की जाय, जमुना माई की जाय, भक्ति देवी की जाय, तुलसी महारानी की जाय, समवेत गौर भक्त वृंद की जाय, गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल। नमो विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति विकास स्वामी नामने। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम अज्ञानतिविरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं शाग्रजातं सगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सगणनिता शिवशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिविकासस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वतदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सकृत एव प्रपन्नो यस्तव सास्मीति चायाचते, अभयं सर्वदा तस्मै ददाम्ये तत्व्रतं मम। सो वेलकम डिवोटीज टू आवर online reading session of the from the book Brahmacharya and Krishna Consciousness. Just 2-3 days back we completed the book Mothers and Masters. Before that, glimpses, Jai Srila Prabhupada, my memories of Srila Prabhupada, speaking strongly on Srila Prabhupada's service. So these books we have completed. We will go on reading those books, but welcome. I'm very happy, we are very honored and blessed that so many devotees association we have got. So on the occasion of Shri Nrisimha Chaturdasi, we thought of reading from this book Brahmacharya and Krishna Consciousness for the twofold purpose. Before starting to speak, I just wanted to confirm from devotees, because I got information from some message that they are not able to hear. But I want to just know from all the other devotees whether they are able to hear or not. Just you can put a message in the chat box that yes, you are audible, I am able to hear, like that, so that I will know that you are all with me. Otherwise, what's the point? I have rejoined. Shyamakundi Prabhu, you are able to hear? Okay, thank you. Audio is perfect. Thank you very much. So on the occasion of Shri Nrisimha Chaturdasi, we thought of reading from the book Brahmacharya and Krishna Consciousness for twofold purpose. One is that it is very good that all devotees come together and read at the same time, simultaneously hear from other devotees how they read, and it will improve our reading skills so that we can become more serious and sincere in Krishna consciousness. We can imbibe that mood which Maharaj and Srila Prabhupada have given us through their books. And another one is to make aware, because people are very few people, of course, many people know about this book, but they should know internally also so many things are written which will inspire them to read Prabhupada's books. So one misconception which devotees have is that we should not write books. Bhakti Vikas Maharaj, why is he writing so many books? What is the requirement? But it is not the case. The point is that by reading, but I don't know about other books, but Maharaj is very clear on his stance that by reading Maharaj books, one will be inspired to read Srila Prabhupada's books. Inspired so much that he will become more cautious to read Prabhupada's books. So we request devotees, there's so many purposes, and one more purpose is to distribute these books. So whenever we start these sessions, we give the link of the book in the chat box, and those devotees who don't have these books, so kindly please avail this opportunity to order this book from us. Even if it is pandemic, we are sending the books. So here is the link of the book Brahmacharan Krishna Consciousness. Those devotees who don't have the book, or who would like to, who are eager to distribute this book to those people who are struggling with their mind and struggling with their senses, struggling, send this book. Will be very much inspiring for them. Even if they don't have struggling, but future they may have. So, but this book will be very, very helpful. So this book is of twofold. So this is the book. So one is Brahmacharan Krishna Consciousness by Srila Bhaktivikas Swami Maharaj, with extensive quotes from His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, and Brahmachari Reader, quotes from Srila Prabhupada and others especially relevant to Brahmacharis. So even Matajis can attend, Matajis can read, Prabhujis can read, Grahasthas can read, youngsters can read, old people can read. So this book is specifically meant for all devotees, those who want to become serious in Krishna consciousness, as Maharaj has given in the blurb, that is the rear page of this book. I would like to read it, and then we will continue to read from the cover page. So this book may accurately be called a user guide to Brahmachari life. The first part consists of elaborate discussion of and down to earth practical guidance on the many aspects of Brahmacharya. The second part is a compilation of quotes from Srila Prabhupada's books, tapes and letters about the subject matter. This book will be relevant and of interest not only to new Brahmacharis in Krishna consciousness, but also to all levels of devotees seriously interested in improving their spiritual lives. So as Maharaj has written, so this book is applicable for everybody, those who want to become serious in Krishna consciousness, for everybody this book is applicable. So this book is very famous. Maharaj is famous. Many devotees, I have experienced, many devotees don't know the face of Maharaj. They don't know who is Bhaktivikas Swami, but they know this book and Beginner's Guide to Krishna Consciousness. So one Brahmachari told me that by writing this book, Brahmachari and Krishna Consciousness, he actually, by default, he becomes the guru of all devotees. So, yeah, they may take initiation from anybody, but Maharaj acts like a Siksha Guru for them. So it's very, very important to follow the principles of Brahmacharya. Everybody, for that matter, want to become serious in Krishna consciousness. So with all those notes, we will start with Mangalacharan of Narsinga prayer. So these are this one. And it is dedicated to His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And it is published by Bhaktivikas Trust. So Maharaj writes here, dedicated to my Lord and Master, His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, the founder Acharya of this wonderful International Society for Krishna Consciousness. He informed us, all ignorant souls, of the absolute necessity of Brahmacharya, trained us as Brahmacharis, and taught us to go beyond Brahmacharya to achieve pure love of Krishna. The greatest benediction of my life will be to be counted among the atoms in the dust of His lotus feet. Other books by Bhaktivikas Swami. So we'll every day we will start with the prayer, with those two prayers recited by Sri Prahlad Maharaj. So this will invoke within us the same mood and attitude which Maharaj has in this book. Maybe in future, by Maharaj's mercy and Prabhupada's mercy, we may also inculcate such a mood, so that we may become a small instrument in the hands of Srila Prabhupada and the Acharyas and the Hari Guru Vaishnavas. So with this small note, what the procedure will be, that I will read for at least for 10-15 minutes, like that, few topics, few pages, and then the same way I would pick up some devotee, those who have proper mic. If they don't have mic, don't struggle yourself by studying from the directly from this one. It will be a trouble. Devotees cannot hear them. If you have a mic, you can put it near your mouth and you can read. And if you have a mic and already the material, whatever is there, is on the screen, that's not a problem. So if you have a proper mic, then you can read. I will give access to devotees, those who would like will read. I will pick up all devotees, specifically Prabhuji's I will pick up, because as we can know, I have already said this. So the point is that I will pick up some Prabhuji's. Mostly those devotees who are initiated, they would have read this book. So I would like to inspire those devotees who are from the names here, they are very new, and they would like to read this book. So those devotees I would like to give the chance to read. Of course, initiated devotees also can. There is no difference between each of those who are chanting. Say bajo, say bado. So we'll start with these prayers. So you can recite yourself wherever you are there. So it is perfect prayer for us every day. Somebody has sent a message. Thank you. Very nice words and explanations from you. Thank you very much. prayers. Om namo bhagavate narasimhaya namaste jastejase avir avir bhava vajranaka vajradamshta karma shayam randhaya randhaya tamo grasha grasha om swaha abhayam abhayam atmani bhuishta om shraum. I offer my respectful obeisances unto Lord Narsingadev, the source of all power. O my Lord, who possesses nails and teeth just like thunderbolts, kindly vanquish our demon-like desires for fruitive activity in this material world. Please appear in our hearts and drive away our ignorance so that by your mercy we may become fearless in the struggle for existence in this material world. Unless one is completely freed from of all material desires which are caused by the dense darkness of ignorance, one cannot fully engage in the devotional service of the Lord. Therefore, we should always offer our prayers to Lord Narsingadev, who killed Hiranyakashipu, the personification of material desire. Hiranya means gold and Kashipu means a soft cushion or bed. Materialistic persons always desire to make the body comfortable, and for this, they require huge amounts of gold. Thus, Hiranyakashipu was the perfect representative of materialistic life. He was therefore the cause of a great disturbance to the topmost devotee, Prahlad Maharaj. Until Lord Narsingadev killed him, any devotee aspiring to be free of material desires should offer his respectful prayers to Narsingadev as Prahlad Maharaj did it in this verse. Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 18th chapter, 8th shloka, text and purport. See also 5, 18, 10 and 14. Yadi dasyasi me kaman varamstvam varadarshabha kamanam hridaya samroham bhavatastu vrine varam. O my Lord, best of givers of benediction, if you at all want to bestow a desirable benediction upon me, then I pray from your Lordship that within the core of my heart there be no material desires. So today we have read the whole thing. From tomorrow onwards, we will just chant these two shlokas and one more shloka. Evam janam nipatitam pravahai kupe kama abhikama manuyah prapadam prasangat kritvatmasa surashina bhagavan grihita soham kratam nupisriche tava bhritya seva. So what I can do is that I will put the verse on the chat box and along with the reference, so that you can every day you can copy it somewhere wherever you want, so that this is from Prahlad Maharaj prayers only. This is भागवतम 7.9.28. So this is the verse. So every day I will recite these three verses and then we will start. Okay, continuing. So the table of contents. Preface. I hope everybody is able to follow me. Is everything is clear? Yes, I suppose. Okay. Preface to the first edition. During the late 60s and 70s, upon the order of his spiritual master, the illustrious empowered preacher His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada brought the science of Krishna consciousness to the Western world. At that time, most of the world was experiencing an increasing degradation and departure from the religious and moral principles. However, Srila Prabhupada gradually introduced a lifestyle hitherto unknown but to a few devoted souls in India. The Vedic culture of austerity for the goal of self-realization. The principles of Brahmacharya formed an important part of this culture. Purified and enlivened by following the teachings and practice of Bhakti Yoga, as authoritatively presented by Srila Prabhupada, hundreds of bright-faced young men and women appeared on the streets of towns and villages throughout the world, taking up Srila Prabhupada's mission to fulfill the prediction of Lord Chaitanya to spread the holy name of Krishna to every corner of the globe. During those years of the expansion of the Krishna consciousness movement, under the banner of ISKCON, the reasoning, principles, and practice of Brahmacharya were often taught and heard in and around the increasing number of temples and ashrams of the society. The devotees became stronger in following the principles of Brahmacharya under the exemplary guidance of the founder Acharya of ISKCON, Srila Prabhupada. There are numerous instructions about Brahmacharya contained in the large body of literature, lectures, and letters left by Srila Prabhupada for those diligent enough to study them. However, until now, much of the principles and practice of Brahmacharya has remained an oral tradition within ISKCON. But human lives and memories are short, and many of Srila Prabhupada's young students are now entered other ashramas or left for other spheres of activity. In order that the purity and momentum of the Krishna consciousness movement not be diminished with the passing of time, many devotees feel that this aspect of the philosophy and application of Krishna consciousness should remain easily and frequently accessible to the present and future generation of devotees in all ashrams and statuses. Okay, just to remind devotees, if anybody has any question, I would stop after a few minutes or after my reading, and then I request devotees, if they have any question for that matter, then they can pose that question on the question box or in the chat box, so that we can maybe one or two questions may be taken, and then we can go ahead to the reading, or they can ask at the end also. So we will allot 5 minutes for that, and then we will continue next day. It's like that. Continuing reading. Therefore, it is timely that His Holiness Bhaktivikas Swami has, with the good wishes of many of his godbrother comrades in active preaching, diligently prepared this compendium of the principles and practice of Brahmachari life. Bhaktivikas Maharaj is respected as a staunch practitioner of these spiritual principles. He is dear to the devotees, especially in Eastern India, Bangladesh, and Southeast Asia, where he has dedicated so many years of his life to traveling and preaching on behalf of Srila Prabhupada. He is certainly qualified to present this book and has done a great service by doing so. This book may accurately be called a user's guide to Brahmachari life. The first part consists of elaborate discussion of and down-to-earth practical guidance on the many aspects of Brahmacharya. The second part is a compilation of quotes from Srila Prabhupada's books, tapes, and letters about this subject matter. The importance of this matter should not be underestimated. Brahmacharya is the basis of all four ashramas and must be practiced by any man or woman serious and sincere about making the tangible progress on the path back to Godhead. Tapasa brahmacharyena shamena cha damena cha. There is no possibility of controlling the mind and senses without following the principles of Brahmacharya. Srila Prabhupada lamented the dearth of educational institutions teaching the principle principles of brahmacharya celibacy and cited this as one reason for the lack of qualified members of the other three ashrams. We pray that by Srila Prabhupada's mercy, this book may help to educate and train the members of the Krishna consciousness movement to seriously understand and follow the principles of brahmacharya and thus be pleasing to Srila Prabhupada and beneficial to the devotees and to the society. We feel fortunate to have met our dear godbrother Bhakti Vikas Swami, then Ilapati Prabhu, just as he was finishing the manuscript of this book and requesting the blessings of ISKCON Publications Board for its publication, and thus be given the chance to assist in its production. Historically, books which present heavy blows to Maya in her work of keeping the fallen souls in illusion have often had to pass through many impediments before finally become manifest. We are glad that after passing through a long series of obstacles, this book could finally go to press. We beg the forgiveness of the readers for any unintentional errors or lack of quality in the present volume. We pray that the readers may nonetheless reap the full benefit of the understanding and determined practice of the principles contained in this book, which may in turn help them to rapidly advance on the path straight back to home, back to Godhead. Butterworth, Bangkok International Express, 27th August 1988, Appearance Day of Lord Balaram. The publisher, Gaura Mandala Bhumidas. Preface to the second edition. It has been about 12 years since the first edition of this book came out. Subsequently, it has been reprinted 3 times in English and also in Russian, Croatian, Mandarin, Italian, Indonesian, and Portuguese, with its total of about 10,000 copies in print. Although there are not 10,000 brahmacharis in our movement, devotees from all ashrams have expressed appreciation of this book, and it continues to be in demand. I just want to see how many books were printed. In 2015, we printed 3,000 copies. Although there are not 10,000 brahmacharis in our movement, devotees from all ashrams have expressed appreciation of this book, and it continues to be in demand. Since the first edition was published, I have collected many snippets of information suitable for brahmacharis. This edition is not in essence different from the first, but gives more of the same substance. I pray that devotees may find it helpful in their ongoing journey towards the lotus feet of Krishna. Dasanudas, Bhakti Vikas Swami. Okay. Okay. I can read, but I would like to allow some devotees to read one by one. So maybe I gave access to Chiranjeevi Ji. You can read a few, 2-3 pages. Then I can tell some other devotees to continue, and then like that.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Dhanavad
Pranam Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Prabhuji, can I start the reading, Prabhuji?
Yes, you can start.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Introduction. Human life, especially the male form, is meant for self-realization. To understand our eternal relationship with God, Krishna, this book is meant for men who have seriously taken to Krishna consciousness, and especially for those devotees who have joined the Brahmachari ashram with no training or background in spiritual life. Brahmacharya means the life of celibacy. Unfortunately, the very concept of such a lifestyle is still incomprehensible to the vast majority of human society, especially in the Western countries. Indeed, even though the rudiments of Krishna consciousness philosophy, service to God, simple living, high thinking, and so on, may be explained to open-minded persons, the principles of celibacy and austerity remains an anathema to most. Some even consider celibacy to be dangerous fanaticism or, at best, something unnatural and strange. This book will definitely not be understandable or to be appreciated by, nor is meant for, the common man. In Krishna consciousness, we stand apart from the general masses. For all their liberty and free sex, their society is a mess, a hell. We have taken the decision to walk on a different path. We cannot compromise our principles to satisfy misguided persons who have no idea that there is a goal of life, let alone how to attain it. Our goal is Krishna, and we are prepared to do whatever is necessary to attain him. Why should we descend to the stool pit of material enjoyment? Brahmacharya.
Hare Krishna, Chiranjeeviji.
Yes,
there's background, some people or devotees, or I don't know who is, they are maybe constantly disturbing. It is. So you can go to a place where little bit there will not be any disturbance. Otherwise, every time, sorry.
Yes, sorry. One second, I'm just requested. Yeah, I am ready to start, bro.
Yeah, you can continue.
Sorry for the disturbance, bro.
Yeah.
Our goal is Krishna, and we are prepared to do whatever is necessary to attain to him. Why should we descend into the stool pit of material enjoyment? Brahmacharya is that training whereby developing knowledge and deattachment, Vairagya Vidya, one becomes immune from the pushing of the senses. Enjoying life in Krishna consciousness and renunciation, one prepares himself to enter the kingdom of God. It is not expected that all brahmacharis will remain so without even ever marrying. The brahmachari period is traditionally a preparation for what will follow. For most, the means grahastha life and beyond. Certainly, if brahmachari is determined and strong, then there is no reason why he cannot remain unmarried throughout his life. Indeed, some fortune few will succeed in remaining celibate throughout their entire lives. But the Vedic system prescribes 4 ashramas, and it is understood that most brahmacharis will eventually marry. Yet one's initial training in Krishna consciousness is most important, and we must give newly recruited devotees a vision of lifelong commitment to Krishna consciousness, whatever their external situation may be. So, brahmacharya in Krishna consciousness shouldn't just mean wearing saffron cloth for a while before getting married. The waiting room. It is a serious training program for both the attached, those who intend to marry, and the detached, those who want to remain single throughout their lives. The more strictly we follow, the more benefit we derive. Of course, brahmacharya is not the goal of life. Krishna consciousness is. Not simply by accepting brahmacharya will one become a pure devotee of Krishna. Indeed, many already married couples take to Krishna consciousness and make steady advancement without ever having had brahmachari training. However, if one is afforded the opportunity for brahmacharya training, he should eagerly accept it, as it is the most best possible start on the long ascent of Vaikuntha. Training and personal guidance are essential, especially for new and inexperienced devotees. Hence, this book is not intended as, nor it could possibly be, a substitute for personal supervision. It can only be auxiliary to such tutelage. I don't know how to pronounce it.
Tutelage.
Yes. Many classes of devotees may benefit from this book. Gurukula students and teachers will find value herein. For despite a boy's Gurukula education, the present social atmosphere is such that upon attaining puberty, sex desire may well hit him like the rushing waves of the sea. How then will he cope? The book will help him. Herein, there is also much valuable information for gurus, sannyasis, temple leaders, and other senior devotees for whom preaching to and caring for brahmacharis is an important aspect of their service. Certainly, every temple president wants to have a team of enthusiastic brahmacharis, for when inspired, brahmacharis render tremendous service. Grahastha men may also derive strength from this book in preparation for the renunciation that they must attain ultimately, accept as vanaprasthas if they actually intend to perfect their lives. And herein, devotee women can learn more about how and how to act cautiously around men. For while the scriptures repeatedly warn men not to be captivated by the charms of women, for women Maya appears in the form of men. As long as man and woman are attached to each other for material enjoyment, they remain dangerous to each other. Grahastha couples should be especially aware of their tremendous responsibility to send their sons to be trained as brahmacharis, to be molded as great personalities and thus be saved from a bestial life of sense gratification. Therefore, this book should be read by all classes of devotees, for every genuine devotee must be a brahmachari, that is, a self-controlled celibate. Indeed, in many instances within this book, the word devotee could substitute for the word brahmachari. Of course, simply to read this book and say Jai will not be good enough, for it is the call to practical action. Although many of the precepts discussed herein are already part of daily life in our ISKCON centers throughout the world, nevertheless, to envil our brahmacharis and to create a strong, healthy mood of brahmacharya, constant and sustained input from older devotees is required. Therefore, I am hopeful that this book will inspire many senior devotees to start taking a more personal interest in the junior men, thus replenishing their own spiritual lives and those of their entire movement. I don't claim to be a perfect brahmachari. Writing about high standards is often easier than strictly following them. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to maintain the highest standard. So we should know what that standard is, seriously endeavor to follow it. If we keep the highest standards, sincere people will be impressed by our seriousness. And if we do not keep high standards, then what is the meaning to our being devotees? This book is therefore meant to give an indication of the ideal standard. Obviously, there will be discrepancies in various circumstances and individuals, and it will not always be possible for everyone to attain to the highest level. Those who are Saragrahi Vaishnavas.
Saragrahi
Vaishnavas, realists, will accept the essence of instructions herein and intelligently apply it in their lives, whatever situation they are in. In this book, I have avoided the complex discussion of Varnashrama Dharma, which is also a focus of attention and concern for the intellectuals in our society. I have simply tried to present practical advice that brahmacharis may apply in their lives. No doubt, some will discuss it as a fanaticism, but without one-pointed determination, has anyone ever achieved anything great? To conquer sex desire is no small achievement. Indeed, it is the greatest accomplishment attainable in the material world. A wishy-washy, a half-hearted attempt will only lead to frustration. Without being fully dedicated, no one will be successful. This book is especially meant to help the many sincere young men who join ISKCON, but it should be also be relevant and of interest to all devotees serious about improving their spiritual lives. It will be hopefully also be appreciated by those brahmacharis who have been in Krishna consciousness for some time, who have a basic understanding of this movement and the philosophy, yet would appreciate guidance on how best to make further spiritual advancement. And some sections of the book are directed more toward bhakta leaders, temple presidents and other senior devotees. There is ample practical advice herein, plus several sections which philosophically analyze the affairs of so-called sexual happiness. I am known for giving strong advice, and although some devotees reject it as impractical, others appreciate it, apply it in their lives, and thus benefit. My guidance is especially meant for devotees who are serious about advancing in Krishna consciousness and are willing to make sacrifices required to do so. Persons desiring instruction for a compromised style of Krishna consciousness may find it elsewhere. My books are not meant for them. I have taken up this task also for my much needed self-purification. Those who know me, that I am still trying to come to the level of real devotee. Those who know me know that I am still trying to come to the level of a real devotee, despite lacking full realization. I have made many forceful statements. I hope this book will not be considered hypocritical. Desiring the mercy of all Vaishnavas, yours in the service of Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Vikaswa.
Okay, Prabhuji. I'll request some of the devotees to read. Thank you for reading.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Okay. Next page. Vivek, are you there? Bhakta Vivek. There are two Viveks. So I am requesting one Vivek. Hare Krishna, Vivek Chari.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Okay. Hare Krishna, is it audible?
Yes, it is audible. So you can continue to read a few, maybe. One second, I'll just see which pages. You can read these two topics and I can request some other devotees to read. Yes, continue.
The meaning of Brahmacharya. Basically, Brahmacharya means celibacy. Karmana manasa vacha sarva vastasu sarvada sarvatra maithuna ityago brahmacharyam prachakshate. The vow of brahmacharya is meant to help one completely abstain from sex indulgence in work, words and mind at all times, under all circumstances and in all places. There are 8 aspects of brahmacharya as described in Sridhara Swami's commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 1st chapter, 12th sloka. Smaranam, Kirtanam, Keli, Prekshanam, Guhya Bhashanam, Sankalpo, Dhyavasayascha, Kriya, Nivrittir, Evacha. One should not think about women, speak about sex life, dally with women, look lustfully at women, talk intimately with women, decide to engage in sexual intercourse, endeavor for sex life, engage in sex life. One who practices brahmacharya is called a brahmachari. In the varnashrama system, the brahmachari ashrama is the first of 4, namely brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyasa. According to Vedic principles, the first part of life should be utilized in brahmacharya for the development of character and spiritual qualities. Brahmacharya is the student life. It was traditionally rigorous, disciplined, and austere. It is a life of cultivation, of preparing for the future. In all ashramas, devotees are cultivating Krishna consciousness, preparing for the examination of death. But the brahmachari period is specifically meant for training. Training in how to control the senses and subdue the mind. Training to be a grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyasi. This training is by submission to, service to, and friendship to the guru. In terms of varnashrama principles, the highest standard of brahmacharya means the vow not to marry, but to observe strict celibacy throughout life. This is called the brihadvrata, great vow, or Naishtika Brahmacharya. Naishtika Brahmachari refers to one who never wastes his semen at any time. The word Mahavrata Dhara indicates a Brahmachari who has never fallen down. In Indian society, Brahmacharya has often been considered as a set of restrictions aimed at upholding good health and moral principles with the ultimate purpose of enjoying civilized sense gratification. Brahmacharya in Krishna consciousness, however, operates on the dynamic principle of knowledge and renunciation, fully engaged in the service of God. Srila Prabhupada, one practicing brahmacharya should be completely engaged in the service of the Lord and should not in any way associate with women. According to the definition of brahmacharya given in Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 12th chapter, 1st sloka, an unmarried person who does not live in Guru's ashrama, who has not submitted himself to the rigid life of surrender, and is not directly and exclusively engaged in the service of his Guru, cannot properly claim to be a brahmachari. The broader meaning of brahmacharya is, as Srila Prabhupada would cite, Brahme charati iti brahmacharyaha, to act on the spiritual platform. The benefits of brahmacharya: Ayus tejo balam viryam, prajna srischa yasas tatha, punyata sat priyatvam cha, vardate brahmacharyaya. By the practice of brahmacharya, longevity, luster, strength, vigor, knowledge, beauty, fame, piety, and devotion to truth increase. Practice of brahmacharya gives good health, inner strength, peace of mind, fortitude, and long life. It helps to conserve physical and mental energy. It augments memory, willpower, clear thinking, power of concentration, and ability to grasp philosophical subjects. It bestows physical strength, vigor, vitality, courage, boldness, and strength of character. To one who practices brahmacharya, divine knowledge comes as if naturally. His words convey meaning and authority and leave an impression on the hearers. Conversely, those who do not practice brahmacharya must always remain in illusion. Srila Prabhupada: Brahmacharya is very, very essential. When one becomes distasteful to sex life, that is the beginning of spiritual life. Without becoming brahmachari, nobody can understand spiritual life.
Okay. Some of the devotees can read. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Krishna Govinda Hari Narayana. Neelakant ji, are you there? Then you can continue to read. This topic is quite nice, big one. Are you there, Neelakant ji? No? Yes? I have given access to the mic, so on your phone or your laptop, a screen, there will be a message will be appearing. You have to click yes on that. Maybe he's not online, I think. Okay. I don't know. Manan Patel ji. So if you have access to the mic, then you can read. Hare Krishna. Manan ji, aap hai? Okay, you have come.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, is it audible?
Hare Krishna.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Now, okay. You can continue to read from this topic. Brahmachari is also a designation. And okay. The next topic, Adi Rasa. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
You have the book, or you will read from this only?
Brahmachari is also a designation. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu declared, "I am not a Brahmana, a Kshatriya, a Vaisya, or a Sudra. I am not a Brahmachari, a Grihastha, a Vanaprastha, or a Sannyasi. I identify myself only as the servant of Krishna, the maintainer of the gopis. The goal of life is not to be a brahmachari, nor a grihastha, nor even a sannyasi. It is to be a pure devotee of Krishna." Srila Prabhupada often quoted from the Narad Pancharatra, "Sarvopadhi vinirmuktam tat paratvena nirmalam ऋषिकेन ऋषिकेश सेवनाम भक्तिर उच्यते. प्योर डिवोशनल सर्विस मीन्स बीइंग फ्रीड फ्रॉम ऑल मटेरियल डेजिग्नेशंस. ब्रह्मचारी इज ऑल्सो अ डेजिग्नेशन. इफ वी पुट टू मच emphasis on making the distinction between varnas and ashramas, especially amongst devotees, we are in the bodily concept of life. For one cannot realize the absolute truth simply by observing celibacy. In India, there are Mayavadi sannyasis who follow difficult rules and regulations far more strictly than most devotees could even dream of. But they are not dear to Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would give respect even to Mayavadi sannyasis, as was the social etiquette. But he associated only with devotees. When he visited Varanasi, Mahaprabhu avoided the numerous Mayavadi sannyasis and chose to live amongst his Grihastha devotees. Instead, Tapan Mishra, Chandrasekhar, Ashudrabai caste, and the Maharashtrian Brahmana.
Yeah, read. What happened? Okay, he got disconnected. Oh, Krishna, this happens every time and now again and again. So, where is he?
Hare Krishna.
You got disconnected, Samudra.
Yes, now.
Now it is audible. You can continue. Yes. Yeah.
The Mayavadi sannyasis were astonished at this and criticizes the Lord. Only after he had converted them to Vaishnavism was the Lord pleased to sit amongst them and take prasad. In considering a devotee's spiritual advancement, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ever considered his external situation. Of his 3.5 intimate associates, 2, Ramananda Rai and Sikhi Mahiti, were householders. Half, Madhavi Devi, was an old woman. And 1, Swarup Damodar, was a renunciate who had not even bothered to accept all the external formalities of sannyasa. Many of Lord Chaitanya's leading devotees were householders and some were rejects from society. Indeed, Lord Chaitanya blessed Haridas Thakur, who was born in a Muslim family, to be the Acharya of the holy name, just to demonstrate that spiritual advancement is not dependent on being respectable according to varna and ashrama considerations. So, we should not be overly concerned with externals. I am a brahmachari, I am a sannyasi. We are all servants of Krishna. Jivera Swarup Hoy, Krishnera Nityadas. The constitutional position of the living entity is the eternal servant of Krishna. The relative advancement of a Vaishnava is understood only by the quality of his devotion to Krishna. Varna and ashrama don't matter. Still, in our present position, brahmacharya must be emphasized as an essential part of the means to our end of attaining love of Krishna. In our present neophyte position, unless we make a rigid program to control our senses, there will never be any possibility of advancement to higher levels. A human being is meant to be trained according to certain principles to revive his original knowledge. Such a methodical life is described as tapasya. One can gradually be elevated to the standard of real knowledge or Krishna consciousness by practicing austerity and celibacy, brahmacharya. By controlling the mind, by controlling the senses, by giving up one's possessions in charity, by being avowedly truthful, by keeping clean, and by practicing yoga asanas. Unless one is master of his senses, he should not be called Goswami, but Godasa, servant of the senses. Following in the footsteps of the six Goswamis of Vrindavan. All Swamis and Goswamis should fully engage in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. As opposed to this, the Godasas engage in the service of the senses or in the service of the material world. They have no other engagement. Prahlad Maharaj has further described the Godasa as a Adanta Go, which refers to one whose senses are not controlled, and Adanta Go cannot become a servant of Krishna.
Yeah, you can read this. Yes, you can read this.
Adi Rasa. Sex is so overwhelmingly present in the material world that the question must arise, where has this sex desire come from? The answer is that sex originates from God. In the spiritual world, Krishna and his consorts are spontaneously attracted to each other and engage in pastimes of love together. This is called Adi Rasa, the original and real sex desire, the supermost platform of spiritual exchange. This Adi Rasa is free from all material contamination and is as different to mundane sex attraction as gold is to iron. Devotees who are without a trace of any mundane desire and who are situated on the highest platform of spiritual understanding, such as Sukhdev Goswami, Rupa Goswami, and Ramananda Rai, have appreciated and glorified this Adi Rasa. Indeed, Krishna himself accepts the form of Lord Chaitanya, adopting the mood of Srimati Radharani, just to taste the full sweetness of this Adi Rasa. When this incomprehensibly elevated service mood is perverted and twisted by souls envious of Krishna's enjoyment, it comes out as a nasty mundane sex desire, which enthralls the conditioned soul and poses an ever-present menace for the aspiring transcendentalist. Why is it that the jnanis and yogis undergo great austerities, strenuously endeavoring to overcome material desires, but still can only make slow advancement over many lifetimes? Why is it that neophyte devotees, despite chanting and praying to God, are still prone to fall down at any time? It is because of sex desire. The perverted expression of Adi Rasa, known as mundane sex desire, is the main obstacle to spiritual progress.
Okay, Prabhuji. This is quite a big topic, so we can read it tomorrow. So before... Okay, thank you, Manan.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So before winding up, another 5 minutes, 4 minutes is there. I would like to ask some devotees to post any question if they have or they want to. Then we can answer them. Sorry, all devotees cannot be given at a time. So Shiv Kumar, Aditya, Sky Kishore, many devotees would be thinking, oh, they would be given chance. I will give maybe next reading. Neelakanth ji, I asked you for the reading, but you were not there when at the time, I think. So no problem. Tomorrow you can read it. Not able to hear clearly, Prabhuji. Maybe you can see the audio controls. Now it is stopped. Okay. If you have any questions, then you would ask. Otherwise, I would read one more topic. I would request some other devotee to read one topic. Otherwise, after that we can wind up. Anybody has any questions to ask? No. Okay. Okay. Neelakanthji, if you are there, then you can continue to read this topic, mundane sex desires. Hare Krishna. I don't know, they're not able to see or what. Krishna Govinda Hari Narayana. You're out. Okay, just forget it. Shivakumar ji. You can read it. Shukumar, you can...
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Okay.
Mundane sex desires. The conditioned soul in the material world is in a state of madness. Noonam pramatta kurute vikarma. Forgetting his eternal blissful relationship with Krishna, he is suffering life after life, being kicked and spat upon by Maya. But he is smiling, taking it as enjoyment. Why? Because he is charmed by the glitter of false happiness, beginning with sex pleasure. Sex desire is the main symptom of insanity exhibited by the conditioned soul. Such foolish beings are always intrigued and charmed by the opposite sex. With the onset of puberty, male youths, especially those who have not been trained otherwise, become overwhelmed by sexual desires. They take every opportunity to mingle with and enter into relationships with the opposite sex. Although they get limited opportunities to do so, their consciousness is always saturated with thoughts of touching the bodies of the opposite sex, seeing their naked forms, and engaging in sexual intercourse. They say love, but they have only lust. Even the more sober members of society who are not cultivating gross sexual lust as their main business in life may be captivated by fantasies of enjoying the body of a sexual partner, for the thought of sex is never far away from the mind of a conditioned soul. But there is nothing intrinsically beautiful about any material body. Even the bodies of beauty queens are simply bags of skin filled with foul-smelling, revolting substances. Blood, mucus, bile, stool, and urine combined as muscles, bones, fat, liver, heart, and intestines, this is what they are having sex with. Sexual happiness is the happiness of uniting the two urine-producing parts. Yet, by the mighty power of illusion, an arrangement of skin and flesh overrides all logic and sanity and brings even a person of intelligence down to the level of a dog. As a pig is attracted to a sow or a male cockroach to a female, so is the sexual desire of a man for a woman. It is not even slightly more elevated than that of the pigs. There is really nothing special about sex. It is not wonderful. It is not noble. It is not romantic. It is just a bodily function, a response to raw gut feeling. If you think about it soberly, the whole prospect of sex seems rather silly. Still, everybody is doing it. The President of America is doing it. The bums on the street are doing it. The cats and dogs are doing it. Only a few great souls are attempting to conquer over it. In human society, sex desire is expanded into many forms under the headings of profit, adoration, and distinction. All the trappings of so-called civilization. Power, prestige, money, and so on are simply for facilitating and expanding this animal instinct called sex desire. But despite its external glamour, unless human society seeks out real beauty, which is Krishna, then it has not advanced any more than the pigs or any other animals. And despite all their emphasis on it, still, as surveys show, many karmis are actually bored at the time of sex. Then why don't they give it up and take to Krishna consciousness, the real nectar of life? Because they know nothing better, don't want to change, and are hoping against hope that sex will make them happy. Those who are fortunate will take to Krishna consciousness for real advancement of life. Krishna consciousness is far above the perversions of the gross materialists and the fruitless efforts of the jnanis and yogis. Even a neophyte devotee can be confident of gradually conquering over lust because he has got the right method, that is, to revive his natural real love, his love for Krishna. If he sticks to the path, then he will in due course of time achieve full Krishna consciousness. then he'll be completely satisfied forever. Brahmacharya is meant for developing clear, unsentimental, uncompromising understanding of these points as the basis for making rapid, determined progress in spiritual life. All the advice given in this book is based on this understanding. Sex cannot make us happy. Only Krishna can make us happy. Devotees who regularly study Srila Prabhupada's books can keep this understanding active in their hearts. Then following all the rules and regulations of spiritual life will come naturally.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. So, devotees, thank you very much for attending this session. And I hope and wish that all devotees please continue to join these sessions until we complete this book, and as and when we start other books also, at least for this book, please come. Many devotees have come. It's over a period of time, what will happen is we might attend now, and over a period of time we get slackened, and then finally there will be one or two left. There will be 30-40 devotees in the initial days, and then it will come to one or two days, two devotees. So I request all the devotees to please attend every day. Please fix your time for 8 to 9 and then attend this every day. It is a very nice quote to end. Sex cannot make us happy, only Krishna can make us happy. Sense gratification cannot make us happy, only Krishna can make us happy. So it will hit our brain and keep in our hearts so that tomorrow morning we can attend Mangala Arati. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. We will meet tomorrow. वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासन्देभिः वचापतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः दन्धे निधायत त्रिणकं प्रदयोर्निपत्य कृत्वा च काकुशतम् एतद् अहमं ब्रह्मि हे साधव सकलमेव विहाय दुरा चैतन्य चन्द्रचरणे कुरुतानुरागात् हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे थैंक यू वेरी मच दोज डिवोटीज हू कम टुडे प्लीज अटेंड टुमारो ऑल्सो सो दैट वी कैन कंटिन्यू टू अटेंड एवरी डे. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Soon we will send this recording to in the WhatsApp chat group so that you can revise or you can send to your devotee friends. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Tomorrow we will meet at 8 o'clock.